Oh my gosh, are you kidding me? Already came off, thank God. Yeah, there is. All right, I guess this is the thing with fish in a swamp.
Oh, is it a bass? Wait, that's a bass. Oh my.
Yo, what's poppin', people? Welcome back to another video. I hope you guys are having a blessed day. Welcome back to another banger. Just feels good to be out right now. The rain has been going on and off. It's been a very windy day. The weather is really weird, but we're gonna have an awesome day today. I'm excited about it. If you guys are new to the channel, please hit that subscribe button, hit the notification bell, also hit the like button if you guys have been enjoying the content. So I wanted to talk about something real quick before we even hop into this one. So I actually dropped a new hat on the website. This is the KTB Cryptic Edition, as you guys can tell. Oh, the cryptic tag right there. If you guys want to check them out, you can. They're on my website, kickingtheirbass.com. I'll link them down below. I only have about 20 of them left. I'm not gonna lie, I put them on the website about a week ago and we sold a lot of them without me even promoting it. And like I said, I got about 20 left. If you guys want to go scoop one, go cop one, they're sweet. I know a lot of you guys have Big Bass Energy hats already, but it's cool to have the old muscle hats coming out. And we got a bunch of other cool designs coming out very soon. We're gonna be fishing this little hidden swamp. We've gone here many a times before. I actually caught my first fish of the year there and it was a giant. It was like 6-7 pounds, crazy. And it was the first fish of the year. There's some massive fish in there. I'm excited to go out there and see if we can hook another big one today. And we're gonna pond hop, you know, we're gonna try a bunch of different ponds. These ponds that you're gonna see in today's video, you guys have not seen in a very long time. So it feels good to just come out and try some different places and see how these fish are acting today. So we're gonna go ahead and hop into it. Thank you guys so much for the support. Let's get it.
So these are the rods that I'm gonna be rocking with today. I actually haven't even showed this. I know I did a iCast video over the new Luz Mach Crush. And this is it, guys. It is beautiful. Compared to the old one, it's not even a question, guys. This thing is awesome. It's actually one of my favorite combos by them. Got the full grip handle, and we have some rain coming in right now. That is not good. But just beautiful color, beautiful design. We have a little Texas rig on that rod. Do not fall. Do not do that. Yeah, but we have a little Texas rig on there. And then on this one, we have a Luz Custom Pro on a Mach 2, and we got a white chatterbait. And I also brought out this little tiny 6-inch bait bag right here, and there's actually some white paddle tail swim baits which we're gonna need, so we're gonna take these out today too. If you guys want to check this out, I'll link it down below. And the rain is coming in, so I'll catch you guys in about 5 minutes.
This is literally what I've been going through the last couple of days. It is so annoying, guys, especially when I'm trying to get out and film some cool content for you guys. It's just been like raining non-stop. Like, I can't get away from this stuff. It's so aggravating, but at the same time, it's a part of it, man. You know, I can't control the weather, and sometimes it's just gonna piss all over me, and there's nothing I can do about it, but it's part of it. This is the part that I don't film, so this is kind of cool too. So I'm gonna be sitting in my car. I'm gonna check some emails. I'm gonna relax for a second, go on social media, maybe go like some of y'all's posts, and I'll catch back up with you guys when the rain calms down.
The moment I shut off the camera, it just automatically stops. Look at that.
Well, screw it. We're just gonna go ahead and head out. There's a little bit of rain. I'm gonna walk out to my first spot. Like I said, it's a good walk, and now it's gonna rain all over me again. Or I might wait a couple more minutes, but I'll catch you guys at the pond when this calms down.
So this is the beautiful pond that we're coming out to today. We've been here many of times before, and there's some really big fish in here. The water in here is actually like a tannic water color. It's not like your normal pond. Honestly, if I could relate this water to anything, it looks exactly like the Ogeechee River water, which you guys have seen me fish the Ogeechee a good bit. This is the little pond tucked away in this corner, and right back there it actually has, right here is like all swamp and nasty stuff, and there's a like cypress trees all back in there, and it actually feeds into this pond. So a while ago we actually walked right over here. I was with A-Dub, and we heard something splashing around in here, and this is how we kind of found this whole thing out. And there's a bunch of water right there from that swamp that like pours in right here, and A-Dub actually ran over there and grabbed a fish with his bare hands. It was crazy. And that's kind of how we found out this whole little swamp was back here feeding into here. And if it floods, a lot of the times there'd be a bunch of water that's pouring over the bank from this swamp. So it's pretty cool. It's a neat area, and there's also some really big fish in here.
So we're gonna go ahead and start casting around in here. I think it's gonna be good. We're gonna get those baits, cover some water, see what these fish are wanting today. Like I said, the last few weeks have just been extremely tough, and the fish have been acting very weird with this weather. They're not stable at all. The weather's been doing all types of crazy stuff, as you can tell by the wind in the background right now. So we're gonna go ahead and get this started, start casting, and hopefully hook a giant today. Look at this wind. It's bad. It is windy today.
All right, so let's get this started. We're starting off with the white chatterdonk today. I'm hoping we're just gonna catch some big ones, guys. I've caught some really good fish out of here. I know some big ones live in here, so let's just hope that we can get a few big ones to bite. Like I said, it's been pretty tough recently, so I guess we'll see. Let's cover some water. Whoa. Something big just followed me in. Are you serious right now? Look at that. There's a huge boil of where I lifted up my chatterbait. That's crazy, actually. I wasn't paying attention. I guess I need to start paying attention when I'm pulling this chatterbait out. Is there something moving right there? Or am I just freaking out? I don't know what's going on. All right, since all that happened with the chatterbait, let's switch up to this little crawl right here. Got this little basic Texas rig, little soft plastic creature bait. Maybe they want this since they're not committing to the moving bait. Throw it in over there. I'm actually dangling it on that branch. Just imagine that. All right, now that should just, right here, we should get hammered. Catch our first, yep, he's on it. Oh, he spit it out. Why would he do that? Right when I threw it in there, there's just something pecking at it, something small. And I just realized I made a huge mistake. I didn't bring any other crawls out here, which I've been really low on crawls, but I'm sure I could have scraped something up. There he is. Got him. Yep. First fish today. Let's go. It's a bass too. Nothing big, but heck, you gotta start somewhere. I really want you guys to pay attention. This is why I love coming to this place. The colors on these bass are awesome, man. These fish just living in this like tannic water. Just make them so dark and pretty. He's got that glow on him. That is awesome. First fish today, it was on the crawl. I honestly was about to switch back over to the chatterbait, but ended up getting one, and he's not big, but guess what? You gotta start somewhere, and that's a good little sign that we caught one. This water feels really cold. Well, that is our first fish. Just praying I don't destroy this crawl. The way that they're biting is just so weird. Like, I'm really paying attention to that, and they're just, oh man, they're biting so weird. I'm trying to do anything and everything to trigger one off the bite. Even by hitting the end of my rod like this, giving that bait a little bit of movement. I think that's what keyed that last fish off the bite. So we've covered this area. We started off with the chatterbait, kind of threw all around here. Then we switched up to a slow moving bait, got that little crawl, started pitching around over here, got one fish. But now that that's slowed down, what we're gonna do is I got a million ants on me and a freaking huge pile, holy cow. Well, that's one thing we gotta be careful about. What we're gonna do now is get this chatterbait and just cover some water. And this thing cast so far. And I just figure out if we can get any of these active bass. Oh my gosh. There's no way. Oh, what? Is that a mudfish? Wait. Yes, it is. There's no way. Oh my gosh. Okay. That is insane. First of all, I've never grabbed one of these. I don't have any pliers with me, so I gotta grab them. That is a dark mudfish. I was getting ants off my shoe and I let the chatterbait sink and this guy just grabbed it. I believe I can grab these by the head, right? Correct? Those are some strong fish, let me tell you. Did you hear them squirm at me? That was weird. I should have brought pliers out. This is not the smartest thing. God, dog. He's, yeah, this is not good. Those things are stronger than I thought, I'm not gonna lie. Oh my God, he came off. That is amazing, okay. Whew. Oh man, those fish are a lot. I've never like actually grabbed mud.
You know, I usually just take the pliers and, you know, just shake them off. And I tried to grab that thing two or three different times and I just could not grip him. He was so slimy and just, wow. Well, okay. That was very interesting. Oh my God. I can't tell if there's another mud. Oh, it's big, whatever it is. Is it a bass? Oh, it is a bass. Oh my God. Oh, it's a good one. Yes. Yes, there we go. A 3-pounder. Oh man. All right, my GoPro's about to die, but look at that fish. Almost a 3-pounder, high 2 if he's not, but I think he's 3 pounds. Let's go. I thought I had another mud fish.
Well guys, one, I'm sorry about the wind. Two, I'm sorry about my camera settings. My GoPro died. I'm having to use my big camera. But that is a beautiful fish, close to 3 pounds. We're gonna get her back in the water, change out my GoPro battery, and hopefully catch another one. That is a good fish. And the markings on that fish, wow. Thank you, baby.
Wow, that is just awesome. I'm hoping we're gonna catch some more like that today. That was just perfect. I'm not gonna lie, I have a huge fray. And like I said, guys, I didn't even bring pliers. I didn't bring cutters. We might have to take a trip back to the car here in a little bit, but I'm gonna last it out to this corner and see if we can catch another fish. That is crazy. Catch a 3-pounder right there. Oh my God. There he is, little tiny guy. So funny how you'll catch like some brute fish in here, just really good ones, and then you'll hook some really tiny ones like this. But that is what, our third fish today, fourth fish, third bass. Pretty markings, pretty colors. Little tiny guy on the curl. So we've actually made it out to a different pond. I went back to my truck, retied this chatterbait because the line is pretty frayed. So we're gonna see if we can catch some fish in this one. I haven't been here in a very long time, and this wasn't always the best pond, but you know, it had some fish in it. So I wanna see if we can catch some today. This is actually where I got the hook in my finger too last year. I don't know if any of you guys saw that video, but it was in this pond right here. But let's go ahead and cover some water with this chatterbait, see if we can get some fish to bite, and then we'll pick up that Texas rig if they're wanting to be really slow. Oh, I got one. Oh gosh, that's a decent one. Oh yes, that's a freaking good one, guys. Let's go. Look at that, that's a good fish. Solid 2-number, look at that. Let's go. Oh, he destroyed my crawl. That's just unfortunate. Calm down, Becky. There we go, look at that. That fish was fighting good. He's a high 1 to 2 pounds. Not a bad fish at all. On that crawl. And I did something. You know how I said I went back to my car and tied on my chatterbait? Well, I totally forgot to grab some crawls for some weird reason. I just picked that crawl up. I cast it around the chatterbait for a good minute. Casted it right off that grass, and this fish had it right away. And that's a pretty one. Nothing huge, but that is a good little bass, and I don't mind catching them like that today. Let's go ahead and get this chatterbait and cover some water since that crawl is kind of destroyed. And if they're not going to eat it, I guess we'll go back to my truck again and find some other crawls. But wow, that's awesome. First fish here, and wasn't a bad one. Oh. Yes, it was worth the walk, boys, and he choked it. Oh, look at how he ate that thing. I walked all the way down to this corner just to fish right here since the wind was blowing up in it. And look at that, got us a fish, and he absolutely choked that thing. You can't get a better eat than that right there. Wow, just about a 1-pounder, but he wanted it. We are getting this video going, boys. Boys and girls, fish number 6 of the day. Nothing big, but a pretty one. It's right in this corner. All this wind getting pushed up in here. He's right where he should have been.
Well, that's good to see at our second pond today that we ended up catching a few fish there. I was really hoping when I walked down this pond that I was gonna catch a few before I got to that corner. But the main reason I really thought there was gonna be a fish in that corner, it just made sense. You know, all that wind was pushing off into that corner, and if there was any fish staged up anywhere, I knew it would be back there. And I walked this whole pond, which is fairly big, and I didn't have any bites until I got all the way in that corner, and then boom. Well, welcome back to the next day. It has been so weird with this weather. It has been raining still, just how it was when we left off with you guys. I don't know what's going on, man. I'm tired of the weather, but I'm actually just gonna bring out my Chatter Dunk and bring out my Custom Pro on a Mach 2. We're gonna hit a different pond than we hit yesterday. I'm hoping to go back to some of those places, but for right now, with how this rain is, we're gonna hit a place that's near me right now and see if we can catch fish. So let's go ahead, grab a rod, get down to the pond, grab a GoPro, strap it on, and catch fish.
The bite wasn't the best yesterday, but at the same time, it wasn't horrible. So I'm hoping to see some big fish being caught today. I really hope that's what happens. There's only one way to find out. It's casting in the water and seeing if we can get some aggressive ones. So it's a little pond that we're coming out to. I haven't been here in a very, very long time. There's some massive fish in here, but there's also a bunch of small ones. But like I said, there's like, when I mean massive, there's some big fish in here. We've caught a few that were disgusting. So let's go ahead and start casting and see if we can catch one. Right here, I feel it. Had some luck in this corner in the past. Hopefully we can catch one right here. Oh, whoa, ho, ho, ho. What are you doing? What are you doing, old Jimmy? Why are you playing with me like that, man? Ooh. What in the world is happening here? It might be really small. That's a good little sign, though, get a bite. It ain't a good sign that they're short striking it, because that's what was our problem the other day when we came out. Oh man, that was so awkward. Okay, so we are back at the swamp pond that we fished at the beginning of the other day, and I'm hoping we can catch a big one. I know there's some really large fish in here. I think it's gonna happen. We just got to cover some water and hopefully get 2 to 3 good bites today. You know, we had a good one last time. It was a solid 3-pounder, and you know, there's a potential that we could catch one that's 5-6 pounds today. So we're just gonna cover some water. I only brought the chatterbait out, which I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, so I'm gonna have to stick to it and hope that we can catch the fish on it. Hopefully they're not gonna be too slow and only eat a slow moving bait, but only thing we can do is keep casting and see if we hook one. So let's get it started. Oh my gosh. Yep, it's a good bass. Let's go. I didn't even move it, guys. Didn't even move it. How you doing, brother? Oh man, look how skinny that fish is. What in the world? No wonder he ate my bait. Look at that. That is one of the most unhealthy bass I've ever seen. I didn't even move my bait there. I threw it out there. It was stuck in the tree. I was hitting it down and he ate it off the bottom. But look how skinny this bass is. He has like a 1.5 to 2 pound head, but I don't even know if this fish breaks a pound. That is insane. He seemed a lot bigger because of his head, and man, that's crazy. Well, that is our first fish. That is a good sign. Heck yeah. Get her right back in the water. That is a great sign, and I think the conditions today are a lot better than the other day I came out here. Let's do it again. What is that? What in the world do I have? Is that a gar? Are you being serious? It is a gar. Oh, he's got my line. Don't do it to me. Oh my God, don't do it. All right. Why are all these weird things happening? After that long walk, I probably should have brought my other rod. I will catch back up with you guys in about 20 minutes. Dang it, I will be back.
Alrighty, we have finally made it back to the pond. Got me an old chattered donk tied on. And this is actually a white and chartreuse one. I didn't think I had this one. So hopefully we'll catch him now. We gave it a second for this spot to replenish. I knew there was a lot of fish over there. So hopefully we're gonna catch him. I'm excited. Well, this is not a light rain. It is coming down right now. And it is just getting worse. Oh, and it's gone. Just like that. What in the world is wrong with the way? Look at this, it's literally going down the pond. It's just, is that not weird? The weather is so jacked up. That was the most random storm I've seen. Oh my gosh, are you kidding me? Already came off, thank God. Yeah. There is, all right, I guess this is the thing with fish in a swamp.
Oh, is it a bass? Wait, that's a bass. Oh my God. Oh my God. There's no way. There's no way. I had a giant mudfish come off and then I was hooked like another 3-pound bass.
What?
Oh my God. Maybe this rain fired him up, destroyed my swim bait. And that is my last one I got. Look at that. That's a good fish. Almost 3 pounds. Holy cow, guys, we are talking right now, boys. Look at that. I had a mudfish hooked. Now I was talking about that's what we get for fishing a swamp like this. You know, we're gonna catch a bunch of mudfish and gar and just nasty fish. And then all of a sudden I saw a wake behind my chatterbait. I was about to pull it away because I thought it was another mudfish or maybe the same mudfish that just came off, and it's a freaking bass.
We'll be right back.